Hello friends, welcome to Insta YouTube Shorts.
Not introduce you to our Rajs and Royals fans. So I think this is the guys who don't follow table tennis. This is Mr. Sharad Kamal, the greatest, one of the greatest ever table tennis champion India has ever produced. We are very lucky to have him today in our Instagram live, and I'm very honored and very lucky to have a small interaction session with you, Sharad bhai. I think with that, I would like to mention small achievements which Sharad bhai has had. I think he has had a phenomenal career. It's still going on. It's very fruitful and very inspiring for all the youngsters. I think he has been an Arjuna and Padma Shri awardee, and he has a very big, unbelievable record of 9 times national champion. I think there's lots and lots of records, and he has won 2 Asian Games bronze and then 4 Commonwealth gold as well. I think it's an unbelievable achievement, Sharad bhai. A huge congratulations for you for an unbelievable career.
Thank you very much. It's also really nice talking to you. 2013 you got the emerging cricketer award. Yes. I think but I've been following you even before that. I think from your early days, a couple of my friends were playing cricket with you. So I know you for almost like 15-16 years now, talking about you.
So have you played cricket? Did you follow much, or did you play cricket when you were young?
I used to follow, never played though. We just keep playing in the camps, simple gully cricket, right, and one pitch, one hand and stuff. But never played cricket.
But I think cricket in Tamil Nadu is very huge. We have a lot of Kerala people going to Tamil Nadu and practicing and playing, and I also come there often to play and practice. It's really
okay.
Tamil Nadu.
Yeah, okay. That's because of the system Tamil Nadu has? Is that because of that?
Absolutely. Yeah, totally agree to that. The league system is really nice. The league is, the quality of the league match is really high.
Okay. Yeah, okay. Really good.
Awesome, Sharad bhai. So how are the preparations for the Olympics going on? How is it?
Actually, it's for 1 year because of the COVID break, put a halt to the preparation. I started my preparation back in 2019, November,
right,
post Diwali.
Right.
So I gave myself 8 months to prepare for the Olympic Games. Midway through, by March, lockdown happened and everything, the Olympics got postponed. So I had to stop my preparation, again pick it up from September onwards, 2020. And it's going on. So now in the final phase, we have the national camp here in Sonipat. And another 15-20 days.
That's awesome, Sharad bhai. So how many Olympics have you attended before? Like,
This will be my fourth. I played 2004 in Athens, 2008 in Beijing. I missed London, okay, 2012, and 2016 in Rio, I played.
Okay, the first one must have been very exciting, I think. When did you go and what age did you
attend? First one, I was 21 years old. So, I really didn't know what Olympics meant back then. But then, okay, I go there and then I see Roger Federer and Andy Roddick.
Okay.
You know, in the dining hall, they're just walking in front of me. So I go as close as possible to them to sit and eat. You know, I'm eating alone, they're eating alone, but I can still say I'm eating dinner with them.
Awesome. Yeah. So how is it now? Is it the same excitement level, or you are experienced enough to calm your emotions down now?
That way it has changed a lot more, but now the expectations are more. Because the level has increased, now we're actually close to getting a medal now. Until 2016 also, we were not close to getting a medal. I was 66 in the world. We didn't qualify for the team. But this time we've qualified for the mixed doubles and singles also. I will be 32 in the world. I'm ranked 32 in the world. So the expectations of a medal is high now. So that pressure is there.
Okay. Awesome. So which is your, like, as we play IPL, I think we definitely expect some big matches against big opponents, like big teams. So are you expecting any good competition in the table tennis matches? Whom are you expecting the most?
Actually, for table tennis, Asia is very, very strong. Like China, Japan, mm-hmm, Korea, Chinese Taipei, Hong Kong. Basically, these 5 countries are really very strong. apart from a few European countries like Germany, Sweden. It's tougher in the Asian circuit. So that is why when we won the medal, bronze medal in Asian Games, we had the hope that at the Olympics also it's possible. Otherwise, it was still winning a medal at the Olympic Games. You know, was a still far fetched thought. But in 2018, when we got that medal, we got confident. Mm-hmm. Okay. Do you? What is your favorite Olympic moment, or do you remember anything as a youngster, anything about the Olympics? Or
to be very honest, I think I used to live in Delhi. Actually, I used to live in Delhi when I was very young. Till the age of 10, I used to live in Delhi. So I remember my father watching Olympics in a very serious mode. Actually, that time, as you said, we don't know like how important is Olympics or how big is Olympics. I remember watching very vaguely, kind of a lot of hockey matches when Dhanraj Pillai used to play. In that time, I think hockey. Yeah. I think I remember watching hockey at that time. But we will be watching very eagerly in this coming Olympics. I think definitely cheering.
Thank you. I think you guys will be in Sri Lanka then, no?
Yeah.
By that time, 24th of July. 23rd of July is the opening.
Okay, I think at 25th we'll be playing our last game in Sri Lanka. So I think yes, we'll be in Sri Lanka.
Perfect.
Right.
Awesome. How is your preparations going on for the Sri Lankan tour?
Really good, but I think we have been. I think if you just keep on playing, I think we don't have an end to our cricketing season here in India. So you keep on playing, keep on practicing, you keep on continuing to have that form. So I think it's a journey actually. So you keep, sometimes you play matches here, sometimes you play in IPL, sometimes you play for your state back home in Kerala. So the one thing I've learned in cricket is you have to be always ready actually. At any point of time you could be called to play the most biggest match of your life actually. So mentally and physically I always just try to be ready and be in my best form as possible. So yes, preparations are going good, but as you know, we have to be prepared throughout our career actually. So everything is going really nice. Thanks for that. So what do you do apart from training, Sharad bhai? I think what are your hobbies apart from table tennis?
I actually like to watch football. Big fan of European football, and now that Euro Cup is happening, but it's a hindrance to our training schedules because currently now we are trying to wake up at Japan's timing, wake up practice. Oh, right. So if we have a 10 o'clock match, it is 6:30 here in India. So I am already in the training hall at 5:45. Euro matches start late in the night, so I'm only watching the highlights. So that is a little bit of a pity.
The preparation is going in really great direction. Whole lifestyle must have been changed. When did you start this kind of a timing?
3 months before when I knew that I qualified. In March we had the Olympic qualifiers. After I qualified for the Olympic qualifiers, I came back home. 10 days I took break, and then by end of March I started preparing.
Awesome. So I heard that you have a very beautiful family. I think you have two kids, one son and a daughter. So how well are they coping up with your pressure, or how much do they support, or do they know something about the game you are playing right now, or are they good enough to understand that my appa is a champion in India? So how do they respond to your sport?
My daughter is 11 years old, my son is 3. My daughter understands pretty much what happens, and you know, also she studies in the same school as I did, so I'm quite often called to the school, and even when I drop her, you know, all the staff, everybody's talking to me, so she knows how it is. For my son, he doesn't care. He just wants me to play. He wants me to play cricket with him or football with him. But my wife, I think that will be the same with you guys also. Family is completely taken care by the women.
household. So without their support, we cannot come this far, and I cannot concentrate on just the sport. Or, you know, I'm actually being very selfish. I'm doing what I like to do. I'm following my passion, and they are supporting us. I think that is something which family sacrifices, because many times people are talking only about us, you know, how we perform, how we do. But behind us, there's so much more to the whole performance and results that goes through.
I will definitely sign on everything you have said. So, do you watch cricket? I think I've heard that Rajasthan Royals is your favorite IPL team.
No, I'm sorry. CSK, and you can see. I'm sorry about that. But really, I loved your innings this season. This season, okay, it was unfortunate that IPL had to go off the things. But how you played last season was very good. But this season, I think you started off fantastic also. You're not...
don't think you miss any IPL matches. I don't think you miss any CSK matches. You miss...
No, in the last 2-3 years, no. I've been living more in India in the last 2-3 years. So, I'm watching more. Before that, I was more in Europe. So, I was not following so much of IPL. Or even, let's say, even cricket for that matter, because there I was following much more football. But then in the last 3-4 years, I've moved back to India. I travel to Europe now. So then now also to have a discussion in the team, in the table tennis team or people around, I need to know cricket now. I cannot talk football to these guys here. So... Everybody
has had a chance to watch an IPL live match or any cricket live match. Did you?
Yes. I've been in Chepauk, in Chennai. I've gone there a few times and I've watched matches. It's really nice. In stadium matches, the experience of in stadium is you cannot compare that to watch it on TV. I think the